All right, welcome to Best Academy TV. In this video, I'll be teaching you guys on center of mass in a coordinate system. And again, I'll also tell you guys more on how to represent your formulas, and I also saw some exam possible questions. Please take note. All right, now let's first of all take a note on this, that is center of mass in a coordinate system. Please write. Center of mass in a coordinate system can be defined as center of mass in a coordinate system can be defined as representing mass in their coordinates, representing mass or masses in their coordinates, representing masses in their coordinates. All right, now what does it mean here? It means that whenever you represent mass in their various coordinates here, we are going to know what coordinate is at that point. Said to be center of mass in a coordinate system. So it means that for you to find center of mass in a coordinate system, whenever mass is given to you with their respective coordinate, at that point you require to calculate center of mass in a coordinate. Please take note. Now, first of all, if I have something like this, if I have 2,1 like this, at this point, this is said to be a coordinate system. Of course, this is said to be X. This is what? Y. Please take note. So if I have this to be 0,1,2, this is said to be 3 coordinate system. This is said to be X. What again? Y. What again? Z. Please take note. So if I have this guy here to be X and Y, it means that we are going to be required to find 2 coordinate systems. That is X coordinate system and what? Y coordinate system. So if I have this to be S, Y, Z, so we are going to be required to calculate S center of mass, Y center of mass, and what is Z center of mass. Please take notes. So let's take their formulas before we solve some questions. Please take notes. Take the formula for S center of mass, that is S center of mass. This CM here represents S center of mass. This is said to be M1 S1 plus M2 S2 plus M3 S3, depending on how many mass is said to be, dot 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 plus MN SN, depending on how many number here, all divide by M1 plus M2 plus M3 dot dot dot. Please take note. All right, now this is the formula here, but you might not actually see this in this way. You might not see it like this in this way. Maybe for those that write OBJ, depending on your school. Okay. Now, we can represent this in terms of summation. Please take note. We can represent this guy here in terms of summation. Okay, sorry for this. I can say SI here. We can represent this guy here in terms of summation. What does it mean here? It means that this S center of mass here is the center as sum of, please take note, N of M, S of I, over N of M, where M is equal to 1, I equal to 1. Please take note. What does it mean here? It means that at the point whereby M is equal to 1, we place 1 here, and I equal to 1, we place 1 here, you get this part here, and get this part here. Please take note. At the point whereby M is equal to 2, you get this part here, that is, also get this part here. Please take note. Okay? Now, this is the formula. Now, representing this formula in terms of summation, is we are going to get this. Now, let's represent Y center of mass here. So for Y center of mass here, this is said to be N1Y1 plus what? M2Y2 plus what? M3Y3, please take note, dot 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 plus what? NNYI, all divide by M1 plus M2 plus M3 plus dot 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 plus what? MM. Please take note. Now, class, let's represent this guy here. Listen, let's represent this guy here in terms of summation. Please take note. So representing this guy here in terms of summation here, this is said to be Y center of mass here will be equal to, class, sum of, please take note, N of N Y of I over N of N, where N is equal to 1, I equal to what? 1. Please take note. Okay, now this is the formula of cost, but representing this formula here in terms of summation is said to be this. So the same thing I told you guys, if you put one here, put I as here, you are going to get the first one here. If you put M as 2, you are going to get the second one here. Please take note. Alright? Now, finally, let's take the last coordinate, that is Z coordinate. Sometimes, you're not, they might not be able to ask you guys about Z coordinate, but let's just take it. It's just the same thing. The only thing that changes is that you replace the coordinate as well, Z. Okay? Let's take the second one, the third one, please. Let's take the third coordinate here, that is Z center of mass. That is for Z center of mass here, this be N1Z1 plus N2Z2, please take note, plus N3Z3 dot 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 plus what? NNZI. All divide by N1 plus N2 plus M3 dot 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 plus MN. Alright, now let's represent this guy here in terms of summation. That's our Z center of mass be equal to sum of, please take note, ZI over MN, where M equal to 1, I equal to 1. Please take note. Alright. Now, class, we are going to solve the equation here, but before then, let me try to tell us more about coordinate system, how to solve some questions, some technical questions. Now, whenever you are given a question in terms of coordinate system, what you just have to verify here is the axis. Now, if definitely the equation is moving on x axis, it means that you are going to calculate the center of mass only on x. But if the equation is moving on y, axis, means that you're only going to calculate for what? Y center of mass. But if the equation is going on S and Y, like something like this, 2, 3, this on S and also on what? Y. So you are going to calculate what? S center of mass and what? Y center of mass. Okay? Now let's take a question here. Example 1, please. This example 1, please. 3 particles of masses, 2 kg, 3 kg and 5 kg are spaced along a line through S axis and S equal to 1 cm, S equal to 2 cm and S equal to 6 cm respectively. Find the center of mass. Alright? Now, there are some things I have to tell you guys here. First of all, let's identify the axis. The axis here is said to be S axis. But if they say Y, that means the axis will be Y axis. If they say, if they put it in this way here, that is maybe 2, 3 in coordinate like this, that means it's said to be what? S and what? Y. Please take note. Alright? Now, at this point here, they specify the axis to be what? S axis. That means the center of mass I'm going to calculate here is going to be on what? S center of mass. Please take note. Now, the next thing we have to know here is on the unit. Now, some person will be like, let's convert before we solve. Please. In terms of center of mass, the unit of the coordinate will take the unit of the center of mass. If the unit of the coordinate is in cm, you don't need to convert. That means the center of mass will be in what? Cm. So if the unit of the coordinate is in meter, that means the center of mass will be what? This class, in meter. If the unit of the coordinate are not specified, it means that the unit is already in what? SI unit. Please take note. Okay. Now let's solve this. Now since it's said to be y axis, that means I will use my, since it's said to be in S, I will use my S center of mass. What is the formula here? It's said to be N1S1 plus what? M2S2 plus what? M3S3 over what? N1 plus what? M2 plus what? M3. Now, why are we stopping at this point here? Because we are giving how many masses here? 3 masses, please take note. Alright? Now, the next thing here is to replace. Now, let's replace this guy. This will be equal to plus. Our N1 is the first mass there, that is 2. Replacing 2 into, what is our first coordinate? That is, what is our first S? It's what? 1. Alright? You replace 1 here. Please take note. Plus, what's our M2 there? Please class. 3 into, the next S will be said to be S2, which is what? 2. please take note, this is 2 here, plus our M3 is said to be 5 into class, our S3 is what's class 6. So everything here over, please take note, 2 plus 3 plus 5. So let's simplify this. Alright, this time this will give us 2 plus 6 plus 30 all divide by, this will give us 5, 5 plus 5 is what? 10. Please take note. So class, let's finally calculate this. Now finally here, this plus this will give us what? 8. This will give us what? 48. That means our S center of mass here, please take note. Our S center of mass here, our S center of mass here will be equal to class, that is 38, all right, over what, 10. So S center of mass will be equal to 3.8 in what, cm, please take note. So if the answer is there, you can just choose the answer, but if the answer is not there, at that point it means that maybe you have to write down the option there and notify the marker that maybe there's a mistake somewhere else. Please take note. All right, now let's take question 2 here. All right, they say find the center of mass of a system of 3 particles, m1 equal to 2 kg at 0.0, m2 equal to 4 kg at 0.3, and m3 equal to 6 kg at 4.0. Please take note. Alright, now if you look into this coordinate here, I told you guys if I have this to be 2.0 here, it means that we have two coordinates here. What are they say to be? S, what, y. Please take note. So the first thing I'm going to do here is to entitle their coordinate first before I solve. So this is going to give us, the first coordinate will give us S1, Y1. This will give us S2, Y2. Please take note. This will give us S3, Y3. So it means that the coordinates here are just on S and Y. Please take note. So the center of mass here is going to be on S and Y also. Please take note. So our center of mass here, S center of mass here, is said to be N1 S1 plus what? M2 S2 plus what? M3 S3 over N1 plus what? M2 plus what? M3. Remember, we are stopping at mass 3 here because we're only giving how many masses? Please take note. 3. Please take note. So let's replace this. Our M1 is said to be 2 into, from the coordinate here, our S1 is 0. Please take note. That is 0 here. Plus, now our M2 is said to be 4. And our S2, this is our S2 here. Please take note. This is our S2 here. It's said to be 0. Please take note. Now, have this to be 0 here. Plus, our M3 is said to be 6. Please take note. And our S3 is said to be 4. Please take note of this. Over 2 plus 4 plus what? 6. Let's simplify this. Now open this bracket here. This time is to give us 0. Please take note. This time is to give us 0. Please take note. Now this is 6 times 4. What is the answer? 28. Please take note. So this will be 28. 24, right? 12, right? 24. That is 24, sorry. Over this plus this will give us 6. That is 6 plus is what? 12. So my answer here will be equal to what's that? 2. Okay? In meters. Alright? Now why is this set being in meters here? I told you guys that whenever the coordinates are not specified, the unit of the coordinate are not specified is set to be what? In SI units. Please take note. Alright? Okay, now we have found them. We have found S center of mass here. Now let's calculate Y center of mass here. That is our Y center of mass here will be equal to plus N1 Y1 plus what? M2 Y2 plus what? M3 Y3 over N1 plus what? M2 plus what? M3. Please take note. Alright, now let's replace this. M1 is already given to us as 2, into our y1 there. Remember this, our y1 here, after specifying the coordinate, our y1 is said to be 0 here, plus our m2 plus is said to be 4, please take note, into our y2 here is said to be 3, please take note. So I have this to be 3, plus our m3 is said to be 6, into our y3 is said to be 0 here, over 2 plus 4 plus what, 6. So this will be equal to class, this will give us 0, 2 times this will give us 0 here, 6 times 0 will give us what, 0. So this will give us 12, that is 12 over what, 12, please take it. So our answer is said to be like 1 meter. So how do we represent our coordinate, our center of mass in a coordinate system? So our center of mass in a coordinate system will be S center of mass, comma, Y center of mass will be equal to class. So what is our S center of mass, please class? That is 2, comma what, 1 in what, meters, please take note. So this is our answer here, please take note of that. Alright, now class, can just subscribe to the channel and get most of the complex question on this. Okay, thank you so much, I really appreciate.